Now, to install e-commerce tracking, you can go to first of all your admin section, and under the view settings, you'll find the e-commerce settings. And here is where you can enable e-commerce tracking and enhanced e-commerce tracking. And all you have to do to do that is click on, and even here on enhanced e-commerce tracking, you can just click on and it will ask you for the checkout labeling. Now, once you have set that up, e-commerce tracking is not yet working. You just made sure that Google Analytics is ready for that data. So once the data comes in, it knows to take that data and put it into the right reports. Now, in order to send over the data, it's a whole another level of installation. Let's talk about e-commerce tracking first. If you go over to the developer section of Google Analytics, you'll find how to install the proper codes onto your thank you page. Very important, the thank you page. And these codes need to be installed to send over a transaction or an item to Google Analytics. Now, in order for this to work, you can't just copy that and paste it into the thank you page, but rather it needs to have a integration with your shop system. And at this point, I really want to refer you to a experienced developer or somebody who knows your shop system pretty well to install that for you if he does it manually. Because, for example, he needs to dynamically pull the ID of the transaction into these fields and then send them over to Google Analytics. And by dynamically, I mean the order details change every order, and that's why this code needs to change in every order. And so this is really a job for somebody who knows the shop system pretty well and knows how to transfer the right information to Google Analytics. And you'll find everything about that in the developer section. I'll link that up in the resources of this course. Now let's talk briefly about enhanced e-commerce tracking. As it might dawn on you right now, the normal installation of e-commerce tracking just on the thank you page, a little bit more complicated than standard Google Analytics installations. And enhanced e-commerce tracking only happen on the thank you page, but rather on every template page. So the home page, the category pages, the product pages, the checkout, and so on. And there are different measurement points where you send over data. And this is all explained in this developer section. It's really an advanced feature and also an advanced feature to implement. So you need somebody with experience who can sit down for an extended period of time, read through this documentation, and then implement it onto your shop system on the code basis. This is not an easy to do task with just copy pasting a line of code into your site, but rather a full-on implementation of different codes on different pages on your website. Now the topic that comes up is always, can't you do this with Google Tag Manager? Yes, Google Tag Manager gives you the capability of doing that a little bit more easily, but at the same time, you need to invest resources in getting the so-called data layer set up. The data layer holds the information that we want to send over to Google Analytics. And setting that up is probably the same work as installing it manually. So a lot of you guys will probably say, oh, this is too much work to do this. There's actually one rescue here, which are plugins. So for your shop system, for example, for this shop system in WooCommerce, there's already a plugin out there that can install the enhanced e-commerce tracking or the e-commerce tracking for your website automatically. Now it's actually pretty standard that every shop system nowadays has some kind of plugin to enable e-commerce tracking on this website. So I would really refer to the help section of your shop system to find out which plugin you can use to enable at least e-commerce tracking, if not enhanced e-commerce tracking. But I guarantee you there will be something out there for e-commerce tracking. And since it's a pretty standard process, pretty forward process, you probably just have to go into your Google Analytics account, enable e-commerce tracking, and into your shop backend, enable e-commerce tracking there as well. And you'll be all set and go to look at the reports within Google Analytics under conversions and e-commerce. Now, if you're looking at this course in 2016 or 17, then there will probably be a kind of adaption to enhance e-commerce tracking. So Google has announced in 2014 that they have started partnerships to get enhanced e-commerce tracking installed by default. This is, for example, the case with the shop system PrestaShop or Shopify. And there's actually plugins out there that enable that. There is a plugin for Magento, I know that. For any other shop system, you really have to dig into what capabilities are there in plugins or default already in the shop system. Enhanced e-commerce tracking is so powerful that more and more shop owners will demand from their shop vendor that this needs to be installed onto the web page by default into the web shop and the shop system. So I would guess in 2016 and 17, we will see this feature coming out by default and you'll see the data coming into Google Analytics. It's just very important if this is already enabled by default and data is coming in, you need to still go into the admin section and enable the e-commerce reports so the data gets processed correctly.